In order to understand recursion, it is absolutely important to know how the function calling mechanism works in C programming language. In simple words, how do I keep track of which functions are being currently in the main memory? After the function completes its execution, where it should come back? Where does the function keep the local variables? Where are the parameters stored? All these questions have answers when you understand what is an activation record. So first, let's try to understand a very simple program to calculate the factorial of a number. I have purposely written from top to bottom by putting main at the bottom so that I don't have to declare prototypes for result and factorial. So if you write the calling functions on top and then you write main at the bottom, then obviously you do not need any prototype declaration. So let's first understand what is the call flow here. When I execute the program, the first function which is going to be called by the operating system is going to be main. Main has a local variable int I is equal to 5. Main is in turn going to call a function called as factorial. Factorial is going to get this I as a parameter which is going to be copied into number. I have an integer variable called as fact. Using the for loop, I am calculating the factorial of 5. And what I am doing is, in order to print the result of the factorial of 5, I am calling another function called as result. In this, I am passing this fact. Fact gets copied into value. So here I am printing the factorial of this particular number, which happens to be 5. So if you looked at the call flow was main called factorial, factorial in turn called result. Now a computer should be able to manage that after executing result, it should know where to come back in fact or factorial. After completing factorial, it should know where to come back in main. And after executing main, or after completing executing of main, it should know where, in which location it should go back in the operating system. Now to answer all these questions, we use a data structure called as a stack. You can think a stack as a box where you can put books or plates one on top of the other. So the way of putting books is, this is the lowest, I put this book, I put book like this, I keep putting books one on top of the other. Now if I have to remove a book, I don't remove the bottommost book. I remove the book from the top of the pile or top of the heap. So the book which went last is removed the first. The book which went second last is removed second last. This idea is used in maintaining the stack frame or the activation record in the stack of each function. A lot of these words will be clear when I go through this example. So let's take a look at this. Let us say we compile this program and click on the run button to run this. So the operating system is going to load, the operating system is going to call the main function. Now the main function, whenever any function is called in C, that particular function's information is maintained in a piece of box called as the activation record or the stack frame. So what does that stack frame contain? The stack frame will have something like this. So when main is called, assuming this is our box, this is our stack box where we are putting items one on top of the other, the details of main will come at the bottom of the box like this. So in the stack box, this is the first activation record or the also called as the stack frame. So in this activation record or the stack frame, for main, I'll have one item which tells me after main completes execution, what location of operating system I should return. So the return location of operating system is stored in this particular stack frame or activation record. Then local variable to main is I. So a local variable is maintained in this particular activation frame or the stack frame. Now, what happens is, in order to keep track of in what next slot is empty in this particular stack box, I have something called as the stack pointer. So stack pointer tells me right now I have only main. Above main, you can, at the next address above main, you can insert the next record. So I am calling factorial. So after factorial is called, the next item in the stack happens to be your activation record of factorial. Now similarly, this stack frame is now going to move up, indicating that the next item can be inserted after this factorial. So try to understand what is happening. Main was called, main is at the bottom of the stack. Main in turn calls factorial, factorial is above main. What does factorial contain? Factorial contains the return address of where it should come back in main. So after this factorial executes, it should know that it should come immediately after the semicolon. So that address is stored in the activation record of the factorial function. In addition, the factorial function has a parameter called number and fact. So the local variables as well as parameters number, fact, which is not shown here, I can just write it. Number and fact are going to be a part of the activation record. Now, if you see here, let's push this a little bottom. Now, if you see here, fact in turn is calling result. So what will happen is when fact calls result, the next activation record happens to be in the stack box, the record of result. Now the stack pointer is going to be on the very top of this particular fellow. So now what this is indicating is, from the operating system, I have called main. Main in turn has called factorial. Factorial in turn has called result. So result is currently executing. And what all result has? Result has the return location to factorial. So after completing executing result, it should know that it should come after this semicolon or somewhere on this line. That is not important. Similarly, after factorial completes execution, it should know that it should come immediately after this semicolon. After main comes completes execution, it should go back to the particular location in the operating system. Okay. Now let me tell you what happens. Let me say main calls factorial, factorial calls result. We have calculated the factorial of 5 as 120. Once we have calculated factorial of 5 as 120, I print the value of 520 and I come at this parenthesis. That means result function execution is complete. Now this record is removed from the stack, or it is called as popping of the activation record from the stack. Putting a record onto this box is called as the pushing. Removing the record is referred to as popping. Now after the result has been printed, even the factorial function ends. So I will also remove the activation record of factorial. After factorial value has been printed, I have also finished main. So I am going to pop this out of the stack box. So this way, what is going to happen here is, as a function is being called, activation record for it is kept creating and kept putting on top of the box. The advantage of having activation records is it keeps track of all the parameters, local variables of that particular function. So activation record of factorial will have values of number and fact. Activation record of main will have only I. And most importantly, every activation record of a function will also have where it should return back after completing execution. Result should return back to factorial, factorial should return back to main. So this way we are able to keep track of the call tree, or how the call is being, function calls are being managed in C programming language. This is absolutely important, because once you understand this, understanding recursion is after all not going to be that difficult. Now in part 2 of it, I'll be telling you a little more about the activation record. So this just gave you a basic introduction to activation record. I'll be telling you about different aspects of activation record in the subsequent video, which is going to be part 2 of this particular video.